5 years.
We've been back to San Francisco, but not to do the money show. I've taken a couple of years off from all the Building Tasty Trade, and it's so cool to be back. Except the Starbucks upstairs is gone. I got all freaked out. I walked in this hotel. I'm like, looking around, where's the Starbucks? Because at the Starbucks, you go down this escalator, and no Starbucks. I don't miss the hotel, but I miss this room. It's awesome. Everybody come out on Friday night. Great. Thank you so much. Going to be fun. I've never actually done this presentation before, but this is not my first presentation, so we're good. But I wrote up some different stuff for tonight, so it's going to be fun. You know, I'm going to close those doors in the back in a second. So I was on my way to, I did my show this morning in Chicago, and I left the office at about 10:30. I had to get out of there exactly at 10:30 in order to make my flight. But every day we buy lunch, you know, for the whole office. It's part of most trading firms and most people in financial business in Chicago buy lunch because we don't let anybody leave. It's part of the deal. You get a job with us, you can't leave. So you have to eat our lunch, which most people like it. But today they ordered like this really good barbecue. So I had this crazy Tom dilemma. Do I run the risk of missing the plane and the entire event for a piece of brisket, or, you know, yeah. This is a really tough dilemma for me, so. Of course I'm going for the brisket, okay? I'm not going to sell out for a good answer, of course. I got to tell you a funny story first. On the way, so I decided to drive to the airport. I don't usually drive, but I decided to drive to the airport today. So I'm driving to the airport, and when I'm driving, you know, traffic wasn't that bad, and usually Chicago traffic's bad, so I can text, trade, and drive at the same time. But today, it wasn't that bad traffic. So I'm going down the Kennedy Expressway, which is like this crazy highway we have, and so I need to know what's going on in the market, because I had some positions that I didn't get filled on when I left, so I called Tony, and I go, what's going on? And he goes, and he's like, starts quoting me the market, and then I see this giant, and I'm getting your O'Hare, and I see this giant cloud of smoke, like a fire burning. And all I can think, I've never gone to an airport, you're about maybe I'm a mile away, and it looks like some plane just crashed right in front of me. And I'm like, oh my God, this is gonna be the worst. Either the flight's gonna be delayed, or I'm gonna have to go through something that's really ugly. Thank God it was a burning car. But from a mile away, I had no idea. So I'm telling Tony the whole story, so I go, you gotta Google this really fast and see if something happened to O'Hare. Because I have to figure out if I have to go to Midway to get out of here and do the whole deal. So anyway, that was it. So I'm sitting on the plane, and you know, it's a 4-hour and 10-minute flight, and we're almost on time. We're like an hour late, so it's good. And I'm sitting on the flight, and Wi-Fi, including United, Wi-Fi United actually works pretty good. And so our new platform actually works really well on airplanes because it's kind of a light platform. And so I open up my computer, I bring up Tastyworks, and because I had a lot of open stuff on, just a lot of stuff to do, and the guy sitting next to me goes, what platform is that? So I told him, you know, this is a platform that we own, and it's a cool little platform. He goes, what are you going to do? I go, I don't know yet. I didn't know what I was going to do. So he's like, I'm like, do you trade? Because I figured maybe I can get another customer, right? So he's like, well, I work for, he named the firm, he works for a big financial service company. So he's like, look, we're not allowed to trade because of all the compliance rules, we can't really trade, we have to turn in all our trades. He goes, but I'm just curious, you know, what are you doing? I said, I don't know yet. And he goes, well, what, you know, he goes, I don't really get it. Because he was watching me because I'm trading and there's bills coming through and they're coming, everything's happening pretty fast. So he's watching me the whole time and I didn't really say a word to me. But I made about 40, 45 trades on the flight out. It's 4 hours. They have plugs. Well, I used to have plugs, so I'd do everything like the first hour. But now they have plugs. So I'm making all these trades, and at the end of the day, he looks at me and he's like, what the fuck did you just do? This is like a total stranger. And he's like mesmerized by this for 2.5 hours when the markets were open. And he's like, I have no idea anything you just did. And I go, well, I was just doing this, and he's like, I've been in this business for 15 years. And I've never seen anybody trade. Forget about like trade activity. Because I guess I've never seen anybody use a piece of technology that really looked like fun. I go, and I kind of looked at like, and I was just trying to be really nice. I'm like, you know, you should try it sometime. Last time I came to San Francisco, I told this story probably years ago, but last time I came to San Francisco for my show, I had somebody pick me up at the airport. And I think I told the story the night I did this, which was five years ago. And the guy who picked me up some limo service that we used. This predates Uber, okay? So it wasn't even a choice then. The guy is high as a kite. And he's like, where are you going? I go, I'm going downtown to the Marriott. And we drove around the airport for 15 minutes. We never got off at the airport circuit. And I kind of figured out quickly what was going on just from the kind of how he was talking to me. And I'm like, dude, you want me to drive? He's like, no, I got this. I go, then, I don't know about the roads here, but I'm like, I think you gotta take the exit, not the loop. We moved five times to the airport, so this time I had a driver and actually knew how to get downtown today, so I'm looking forward to it. So anyway, I got a brand new presentation for tonight. I ran into somebody when I got here, and they said, I would love to come to your event tonight, but I don't know anything about options, and I just came to the money show because it looked really interesting, and I thought I could learn some stuff about, you know, finance and managing money and all this other stuff. And Hobie's here. And I was like, well, don't worry, because I'm not even talking about options. He goes, well, they all told me that you're going to be talking about options. I go, don't worry about it. I'm not talking about options tonight. He goes, well, what are you talking about? I go, I'm talking about life. He's like, you're talking about life? What does that mean? I go, you have to come and see. So I got kind of a fun discussion about business, entrepreneurship. It's kind of been my focus. If you want to learn option strategies and you want to think about derivative strategies and quantitative analysis and all the strategic stuff we do it for 8 hours a day, every day live. And we're junkies. So we produce more content than anybody else in the industry, I think, combined. And so you can watch that anytime. They're all archived and you can see all that. I think it's important we have an opportunity to speak, you know, at an event like this. And it's an awesome turnout.